Welcome to Morning Prayer. Let all the earth acclaim God, sing to the glory of his name, make his praise glorious. Blessed be the Lord our God, by whose grace we are yet alive. Blessed be his Son, Jesus Christ, by whose rising we are set free. Blessed be the Spirit of God, in whom is our hope and our joy. Yeah.
jubilati. Oh, shout to the Lord in triumph, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness and come before his face with songs of joy. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who has made us. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Come into his gates with thanksgiving. Come into his courts with praise. Give thanks unto him and bless his holy name. For the Lord is good. His loving mercy is forever. His faithfulness throughout all generations. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever.
Bearing our trespasses and sins and everything that would hurt our Savior, Jesus Christ, we ask God for his forgiveness. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Set us free from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Psalms 41 and 52. Psalm 41. Happy are they who consider the poor and needy. The Lord will deliver them in the time of trouble. The Lord preserves them and keeps them alive, so that they may be happy in the land. He does not hand them over to the will of their enemies. The Lord sustains them on their sick bed and ministers to them in their illness. I said, Lord, be merciful to me. Heal me, for I have sinned against you. My enemies are saying wicked things about me. When will he die and his name perish? Even if they come to see me, they speak empty words. Their heart collects false rumors. They go outside and spread them. All my enemies whisper together about me and devise evil against me. A deadly thing, they say, has fastened on him. He has taken to his bed and he will never get up again. Even my best friend, whom I trusted, who broke bread with me, has lifted up his heel and turned against me. But you, O Lord, be merciful to me and raise me up, and I shall repay them. By this I know you are pleased with me, that my enemy does not triumph over me. In my integrity you hold me fast, and shall set me before your face forever. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, from age to age. Amen. Amen.
Psalm 52. You tyrant, why do you boast of wickedness against the godly all day long? You plot ruin. Your tongue is like a sharpened razor, O worker of deception. You love evil more than good and lying more than speaking the truth. You love all words that hurt. Oh, you deceitful tongue. Oh, that God would demolish you utterly, topple you, and snatch you from your dwelling and root you out of the land of the living. The righteous shall see and tremble, and they shall laugh at him, saying, "This is the one who did not take God for a refuge, but trusted in great wealth and relied upon wickedness." But I am like a green olive tree in the house of God. I trust in the mercy of God forever and ever. I will give you thanks for what you have done and declare the goodness of your name in the presence of the godly. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
A reading from the book of 1 Kings, chapter 13, beginning at verse 1 through verse 10. While Jeroboam was standing by the altar to offer incense, a man of God came out of Judah by the word of the Lord to Bethel, and proclaimed against the altar by the word of the Lord, and said, "O altar, altar, thus says the Lord, a son shall be born to the house of David, Josiah by name, and he shall sacrifice on you the priests of the high places who offer incense on you, and human bones shall be burned on you." He gave a sign the same day, saying, "This is the sign that the Lord has spoken. The altar shall be torn down, and the ashes that are on it shall be poured out." When the king heard what the man of God cried out against the altar at Bethel, Jeroboam stretched out his hand from the altar, saying, "Seize him!" But the hand that he stretched out against him withered, so that he could not draw it back to himself. The altar also was torn down, and the ashes poured out from the altar, according to the sign that the man of God had given by the word of the Lord. The king said to the man of God, "Entreat now the favor of the Lord your God, and pray for me, so that my hand may be restored to me." So the man of God entreated the Lord, and the king's hand was restored to him, and became as it was before. Then the king said to the man of God, "Come home with me and dine, and I will give you a gift." But the man of God said to the king, "If you give me half your kingdom, I will not go with you, nor will I eat food or drink water in this place. For thus I was commanded by the word of the Lord, 'You shall not eat food or drink water, or return by the way that you came.'" So he went another way,
and did not return by the way that he had come to Bethel.
The Word of the Lord. Song of Moses. I will sing to the Lord for his glorious triumph, the horse and the rider he has hurled into the sea. The Lord has become my strength and a refuge. The Lord himself has become my savior. He is my God, and I will praise him. My father's God, and I will exalt him. The Lord himself is a mighty warrior. The Lord is his name. Your right hand, O Lord, is majestic in power. Your right hand, O Lord, shatters the enemy. Who is like you, O Lord, among the gods? Holy, awesome, worker of wonders. In steadfast love, you led your people. You guided your redeemed with your great strength. You brought them in safety to your holy place and planted them firm on your own mountain. You brought them into your own house. The Lord shall reign forever and ever. A reading from the book of Mark, chapter 15, beginning at verse 40 through verse 47. There were also women looking on from a distance. Among them were Mary Magdalene and Mary the mother of James the younger, and of Joses and Salome. These used to follow him and provided for him when he was in Galilee. And there were many other women who had come up with him to Jerusalem. When evening had come, and since it was the day of preparation, that is, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathea, a respected member of the council, who was also himself waiting expectantly for the kingdom of God, went boldly to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then Pilate wondered if he were already dead. And summoning the centurion, he asked him whether he had been dead for some time. When he learned from the centurion that he was dead, he granted the body to Joseph. Then Joseph brought a linen cloth, and taking down the body, wrapped it in the linen cloth, and laid it in a tomb that had been hewn out of the rock. He then rolled a stone against the door of the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary the mother of Joses saw where the body was laid. The Word of the Lord. Thank you.
still my soul, the Lord is on thy side. Bear patiently the cross of grief or pain. Leave to thy God to order and provide. In every change, he faithful will remain. Be still my soul, thy best, thy heavenly friend. Through thorny ways leads to a joyful end. Be still my soul, thy God doth undertake to guide the future as he has the past. Thy hope, thy confidence, let nothing shake. All now mysterious shall be bright. Still my soul, the waves and winds still know his voice who ruled them while he dwelt below. In you I rest, in you I found my hope, in you I trust. You never
prophet and the man of God. I speak to you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the book of 1 Kings, chapter 13, we have a tragic story with a very important lesson for us today. This story is of an incident involving two men of God, an unnamed old prophet and a similarly unnamed man of God. It goes like this. God sent a man from the southern kingdom of Judah with a prophetic message for King Jeroboam of the northern kingdom of Israel. The man of God was to denounce the heathen altar that the king had built in Bethel and to announce that a future king of Judah called Josiah will invade Israel and burn on that very altar the heathen priests who sacrificed there. God also instructed the man of God that after making his pronouncements, he should neither eat nor drink anything in that land, not even water. Neither should he go back the way he came. The man of God did as God had instructed. but not exactly as God had instructed. Yes, he confronted the king Jeroboam and made his pronouncements precisely as God had said. He did so just as the king was about to make a sacrifice. And yes, he also refused the king's offer of a meal and a gift exactly as God had asked. The king had tried to arrest the man of God, but immediately King Jeroboam's pointing hand withered. It was healed only after he begged the man of God to pray for him. The king then invited the man of God to have a meal with him and to receive a gift. However, in obedience to God, the man of God refused. He then proceeded, as God had instructed, on another route. Now, that would have been the end of the story, except for the swindling old prophet. An old Israelite prophet from Bethel, hearing from his sons of the showdown between the king and the man of God, and perhaps hoping to impress the king, found out where the prophet was headed and rode after him. He was able to catch up to the man of God who had stopped to rest on the tree. It appeared that he was traveling on foot. The old prophet invited the man of God to return for a meal. The man of God repeated to him God's instructions about neither eating nor drinking in Bethel. However, the old prophet, pointing out that he too was a prophet, then lied, saying that an angel of the Lord had visited him and instructed him to bring the man of God home with him for a meal and some water. On hearing this, and perhaps being hungry and thirsty, and also feeling validated by the company of this senior prophet, he was willing to believe the senior prophet, so he went back to Bethel with the old prophet. But while he was eating, and while he was drinking, the word of the Lord came to the old prophet. God told the old prophet to prophesy to the younger prophet and to tell him that because he had disobeyed God and ate and drank in Bethel, he will never arrive home alive. He will never be buried in his ancestral home in Judah. What an irony. After the meal, the old prophet saddled the donkey for the young prophet and sent him away. However, on his way home, a lion attacked the man of God, killed him, and flung his body into the street. The old prophet, on hearing of it, took the body back to Bethel and buried it in his own tomb. Brothers and sisters, friends, what can we learn from this story? Many years ago, a ministerial colleague of mine, citing this story and quoting yet another ministerial colleague of his, told me that his takeaway from this story was this. He said, "Know God for yourself. It is not enough to be impressed by other ministers, even senior ones who say, 'God told me this,' or 'God said that.' We must hear from God for ourselves. You and I have the same Holy Spirit they have. The Holy Spirit will confirm with you any message that he gave to them. So remember, while it is okay to pay respect to prophets and to prophetic utterances, know God for yourself." In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You never let me go.
Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, He rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
The Suffrages. Suffrage C. Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance. Govern and uphold them now and always. Day by day we bless you. We praise your name forever. Lord, keep us from all sin today. Have mercy on us, Lord, have mercy. Lord, show us your love and mercy, for we put our trust in you. In you, Lord, is our hope, and we shall never hope in vain. The Collect. Grant us, O Lord, to trust in you with all our hearts. For as you always confound the proud who confide in their own strength, so you never forsake those who make their boast of your mercy. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Father God, may we live closely to you, close enough to hear your voice. May you empower us by your Spirit to act on your behalf. And may we, regardless of external noise and superior influence, willingly obey your instructions. We pray for your Holy Church, the Church in the province of the West Indies. We pray especially for our Archbishop, the Most Reverend Howard Gregory. We pray for our diocese, the Diocese of Trinidad and Tobago. You have called us in this diocese, O God of grace, to a goodly fellowship of faith. Bless our bishop, the Right Reverend Claude Berkeley, and retired bishops, Clive and Calvin. We also ask for your blessing upon all of the clergy in our diocese and upon all our people. Grant that your word may be truly preached and truly heard, your sacraments faithfully administered and faithfully received. By your Spirit, fashion our lives according to the example of your Son, and grant that we may show the power of your love to all among whom we live. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We commend to you and your fatherly goodness all who are in any way afflicted or distressed in body, mind, or spirit. Comfort and receive them in their necessities. Give them patience under their sufferings, and bring good out of their afflictions, O Lord. Lord God Almighty and Everlasting Father, you have brought us in your safety to this new day. Preserve us with your mighty power, that we may not fall into sin nor be overcome by adversity, and in all we do, direct us to the fulfilling of your purpose. Through Jesus Christ, O Lord. Amen. prayer of dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us evermore. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God.